Just as much as variables are very important in programming, so are loops, and so are if-then-else statements, conditions, okay? Because programs need to know how to make decisions. And if-then-else is one of the main ways that a program learns how to make a decision. So let me show you what we mean. We're going to create a program now that when you shake the microbit, it's going to generate a random number, either 0 or 1. If it's a 0, that's going to then show us a sad face. Or if it's a 1, it's going to show us a happy face. Okay, so let's have a look. The first thing we're going to do is create a variable called emotion. Emotion. Okay, so we have our variable called emotion. There it is there. Are you guys with me so far? Yeah? Good. Then we have our input on shake. We're going to shake it. Okay. And we're then going to go and say, right, when we shake the microbit, set the value of emotion to 1 or 0. So we need to do the whole random number again. So here it is here. Pick random. There we go. Between 0 and 1. Right. So what we've got so far, we shake the microbit up and it takes the value of 0 or 1, depending on what it chooses, and puts it into the variable emotion. So what do we do next? Right. This is our logic. All right. This is logic. If, then, else. Here we go. So here we have if, then, else. There it is. If, then, else. Click on that, pop it underneath. So what are we going to do if something is true? So what is true? Let's do it with the 0 first. We'll start off with 0. So again, back to my logic. There it is there. And we're comparing something equals something. Okay, let's have a look. Okay, you'll notice the shapes. See that sort of diamond shape? Okay, I'm sure there's a better name for it. I don't know. There it is there. If 0 equals 0, well, that's not going to help us very much. So let me show you what we will do. If emotion, here we go. If the value of emotion equals, not any of these other ones, okay, equals 0, then what are we going to do? We're going to show an icon, and we're going to show a sad face. There he is there. And this is the best part, because there are only two conditions. If it's not 0, it's 1. If it's not 1, it's 0. Do you see? It's one or the other. That's the best part about this exercise. So, if the emotion is equal to 0, then show the icon sad face. Else, what do we do? Well, else we show a happy face. So, show icon happy face. And he is over there. Let's see what it does. Shake. Happy face. So that was obviously a number 1. Another number 1. A 0. A 0. Number 1. So let's go through this quickly. On shake, when we shake the microbit, set the value of the variable emotion to pick a random number 0 or 1. So set the value to 1 or 0 randomly. If the emotion equals 0, then show the sad face, otherwise show the happy face. That's your introduction to if then else. Pretty straightforward, but it can get more complicated. The next activity you'll see is actually a little bit more complicated, but not too difficult to understand.